Hey y'all, so procrastination is just my worst enemy. It really is. This is The Real Housewives of Atlanta, season 13, episode 7. Unlike the last six episodes, this one was actually a little bit more entertaining because all the ladies were together for the first time. And I'm like, really? Has it really been like six episodes? I remember they all got together at Cynthia's, but I think one of them was missing. So I think this is the first time that all the main cast members are together. It's sad, huh? It's sad. Anywho, let's get into the episode. So we open with Cynthia driving. I'm guessing she's on her way to see Candy. We see Candy and Ty. They're on FaceTime with Riley. And I'm not sure if Riley was just like shading herself with the "can you believe I have friends" comment, because, you know, we've seen her grow up and the girl is awkward. So I am surprised she has friends, actually. Wow, so we're just jumping all around. So Kenya's now talking about how fat her fingers have gotten to some woman on FaceTime. I'm thinking that's her marketing person. It can't be a friend, because Kenya doesn't have friends. She only has, like, you know, minions. So now we're with Drew with her fine but problematic husband. And I gotta say, y'all, like, Drew in these wigs, I hope she got it together. Like, seeing herself on TV, because the hair just has not just been right since I've seen her on my screen. So in this scene, they're just walking around the neighborhood as Drew is on her scooter. It looks like her quarantining is over, because now she can be around the other ladies. She's definitely going to be on this South Carolina trip. And before the trip, she's going to have a nice gathering at her house. Also in this scene, her husband is actually being nice to her. So next scene, we're with Kenya, and y'all just already know I'm going to comment on what she's wearing right now. I don't know what this turquoise loofah shirt that she has on, loofah blouse, loofah short sleeve blouse sweater. I don't know what that is. It's not cute. She's meeting with her minion Toya for lunch. LaToya is just so beautiful, yet she's just so annoying. She really is like Kenya, right? So it looks like they're still trying to play this little bisexual angle right now. It's really tired, but Kenya bought her some underwear that she intentionally bought for herself, but just gave it to LaToya because she never wore them. Okay. So then LaToya looks at the underwear and then smells it. I kid you not, on TV, on Bravo. Yep. And you know it's crazy, because we're in episode 7. You know, I still don't know that much about LaToya. I know how devoted LaToya is to Kenya, though, but it's so crazy. Like, I know Marlo. She's a good friend of, you know, that's how she stayed on the show so long. Like, people know Marlo. But with LaToya, it's just, who are you, sis? Like, all I know is you're Kenya's friend. That's all I know about you. So Kenya and LaToya are talking about the upcoming trip, and this is where we hear that Kenya rented a private jet for them to go from Atlanta to South Carolina. That is so extra. Like, how short of a trip is that? But anywho, what's messy is Kenya just arranged a private jet, not for herself and the other ladies, just one of the ladies who isn't a cast member, someone she hasn't known that long, and also her nanny and her child. That's it. The other ladies will be traveling by, I'm guessing, like a van, like a luxury van or some shit. But why? Like, it just seems just messy. Like, if you can't afford, basically she just said she couldn't afford a jet to house all of the ladies and herself, then why just get it for her and one person? I don't know. I just think she's going above and beyond to be messy. And if that was the case, how come she wasn't on board in the last episode when Portia suggested that Fallon use her private jet? See, it just don't make no sense. Kenya chooses violence every episode, y'all. So in the midst of their conversation, Kenya gets a phone call from Drew, and Drew's inviting her to the dinner. Of course, Kenya just adds on a plus one to a dinner where LaToya probably isn't wanted, but she says, "Oh, can LaToya come?" And Drew says, "Yeah, she could come." Kenya brings up her status with Mark right now, and girl, we know. Y'all been separated for a year. Y'all ain't getting back together. Y'all were together for that baby. You wanted a baby and a man. The man didn't want you. He wanted some fame from Housewives, you know, to promote Soho. He didn't want you. I heard recently that Mark put out a statement saying him and Kenya will not be getting back together. So, yeah, that storyline is dead. So it's the next day and we're at Drew's house and she's getting ready to host all the women for dinner. I do not know what she's wearing right now. I like the blazer. She kind of lost me at the pants. The pants are forgivable. It's forgivable though. The hair. I don't like it. I just don't like it, y'all. Tell me what y'all think in the comments, what y'all think about her hair. I don't like it. I don't like it at all. Her style is almost like Giselle, but not as chaotic. So all the ladies are arriving, slowly but surely. It looks like Drew is having some doorbell issues. Maybe it's just not loud enough, or I don't know. Maybe the door is just too far away from everything. But yeah, everyone had issues getting in. Also, something else I noticed. Next time I watch Real Housewives of Atlanta, I'm gonna take a shot every time Cynthia says wedding. Hopefully, I don't pass out. I will do this on camera. So, the next episode, I will take a shot on here every time Cynthia says wedding. And we'll see how that works out. So, Portia's the last to arrive. I'm loving the red hair on Portia. I think Portia rarely gets it wrong when it comes to the hair department. And yeah, so this is the scene where we see all five main cast members in one sitting. It just really annoys me that it took 7 episodes. 7. And look at Ralph. You know, I see he's an actor too because his role tonight is playing the part of a good husband. So we see that LaToya decided not to go to Drew's dinner, and I'm thinking maybe production told her to like fall back and just let the five main cast members be on here. Like peach holders only type T. Cause I don't think LaToya would miss out on a chance of camera time. Ooh, and Portia's stirring the pot. She's like, well, you should be glad LaToya didn't come because she was talking about you. She's talking about your wig. And you know what? I would be Portia too. I'd be like, girl, don't be nice to her because she was talking about you like a dog. And actually, they were. Like, Kenya called her a stray. And then LaToya said she had a pet on her head. And what sucks is Drew didn't do nothing to nobody. Like, she's really nice. So why even just come for her? Like, I could see if she was messy or something. Or did something, like, out of pocket. But she didn't even do anything yet. And she didn't even meet LaToya. Okay, Drew. What we're not gonna do is shade the YouTubers. YouTube is a job. There's a check involved. It can be a nice check too. So let's not shade YouTubers. I know LaToya is annoying and I know she does YouTube as well, but let's not shade all of YouTubers. Please. When I saw this scene, I was like, oh, damn. Well, damn, Portia, tell her everything. She said not only did LaToya talk about your wig, but she did say it in front of everybody. Cynthia and Candy right here too. They knew as well. They just didn't tell you like I did. So we're getting to know LaToya at the dinner table, and I like how the plot is moving along, finally, like something is happening on this show. So she also mentions that she sings as well, and it was like, oh, why don't you sing a little something? Now, I've learned, because one of my best friends is an opera singer, never to ask a singer on the spot to sing for you. They are not a jukebox. My friend's response is usually, oh, are you gonna pay me? Because I get paid to sing. I don't sing for free. And that's why I do not ask singers, oh, can you sing something on the spot? But LaToya decides to sing Amazing Grace. Why does everyone want to sing that song? Anywho, she does a really good job. Like, better than Portia, if y'all remember. The producers also remind us as well. I forgot how funny that reunion moment was when Portia just stood up and started singing Amazing Grace. Amazing Grace. Yeah, Portia, you sang it first, but you didn't sing it better. So ladies are discussing South Carolina, and Kenya brings up to them like, okay, y'all are all gonna meet by Candy's place. Y'all are gonna be on a sprinter that I provided for y'all. And then me and LaToya are gonna get there before all of y'all just to set things up. So then Drew says, oh, well, we're getting on a sprinter. Like, how y'all getting there? Y'all have your own sprinter? Kenya says, well, no. And she was like, well, how y'all getting there? It's COVID. Kenya says in her confessional that, oh, well, Drew is sneaky because I told her not to tell the other ladies about it. Now, okay, can you want to call her sneaky, but you're trying not to tell everybody that you rented a private jet just for you and your butt buddy. And the thing is, she texts Drew, don't tell the other ladies that I'm doing this. I don't get that. And then, of course, it gets the reaction that it should be. Like, I don't know, it's just rude. Like, I can see if you get the best room, but then your transportation is different from everybody, too. So just out of curiosity, y'all, I was just Googling, how much is it to rent a private jet? And here's what Google says. You can expect to pay between $1,300 and $3,000 per flying hour on average for a low-cost private jet service. And then $4,000 to $8,000 per flying hour for a mid-size, super mid-size jet. So that's what that meant. She couldn't afford to travel all the ladies, but she can afford like $1,300. And I think she did it right on the hour too, knowing Kenya. So it was between $1,300 and $3,000. So not that big of a deal. I mean, Candy could have like done it, but I mean, Candy's cheap and she's not extra like that. So the dinner ends and, you know, Kenya just says, I got my eye on her and her poodle wig. I mean, Kenya, it's whatever. Like, yes, Drew was a little messy saying that, you know, she already got the text message and she still tried to get her to say it. But, I mean, it is what it is. So next scene, we see Cynthia and Noelle. It looks like they're having a moment while she's packing. Ooh, you know I'm gonna fast forward through this. Next, we see the other ladies are just packing. We see that LaToya still is wearing some crazy wigs right now. I don't know if it's on purpose, but baby girl, please. She is too pretty for this. Like, get it together. She's like Giselle with clothes as she is with wigs. That's what it is. Yeah, it looks like we're going from housewife to housewife to see what they're doing to pack for the trip. We see Portia. She's just making arrangements of who's going to take care of her kid. And now we're with Todd and Candy. I think I'm going to fast forward through this because I don't really care what they're talking about. So it looks like I can't fast forward through this scene because Candy and Todd are talking about putting on the festivities for the bride and the groom, for the bachelor and the bachelorette parties. Todd wants to do strip club during a pandemic. I'm not sure why, but you know, they're in Atlanta and everything is open. So I guess that can happen. And then Candy, she's like, oh, well, maybe I could get some strippers. I thought they were going somewhere else for this stripper party, but I'm guessing the stripper party's in South Carolina. But yeah, it's interesting that these two are the ones that are the facilitators of the strippers. And it looks like they're going to be calling people from their dungeon party. So they got the hookup when it comes to exotic dancers. So next scene, we're at Kenya's ditch, and they're getting ready to drive to the airport so they can get on their private jet to South Carolina. What's funny is LaToya also calls this place a ditch because her luggage just goes flying. Because I'm guessing it's just so steep to where Kenya's house is, the luggage was just rolling by itself. So as they're driving to the airport, Kenya lets LaToya know that Portia was telling Drew what LaToya said about her hair. And LaToya has the nerve to call Portia extra. Portia's extra, but LaToya is the one, you know, showing Kenya's nudes at a dinner table. She's calling Portia extra, but she's sniffing underwear that was purchased for her in the middle of a restaurant. Okay. They are really excited about this private jet. Now, a private jet from Georgia to South Carolina, it's not a flex. Do a private jet like, you know, across the country or to a foreign destination, then that's a flex because they charge you by the hour. Okay, she put out $1,300 to $3,000. That's a handbag for them. So it's not that big of a flex, Kenya. So all the ladies are now meeting by Candy for this little bus that Kenya got for them. We see that Portia is escorted by none other than the hot dog king himself, Dennis. I thought they weren't together, so it looks like they have a complicated situation going on. I honestly do not care about Portia's storyline with Dennis. With Portia, I just want her to have fun, I want her to interact, and I want her to throw shade. That's like, whatever she do with Dennis, I don't care. So we see Portia, Shamia, and Candy being all buddy-buddy, and then the producers just had to remind us of the war between Candy and Portia. Like, I thought we got over that hill. But they have come a long way. And I will say it again. If Candy can forgive Portia, she can forgive Phaedra. So the rest of the ladies get there. They all board the bus. We see Marlo came in a whole hazmat suit. I mean, I don't expect anything less from Marlo. And it looks like they're ready to go. They also mention that the bus is very hot. So they're all trying to get the tea on Portia's relationship with Dennis. And like I said, I don't care. They are going back and forth, back and forth. I don't care. They're not getting married anytime soon. So I'm just going to fast forward through this situation. Oh, wow. They gave Shamia her own confessional spot. Okay. That is a big raise for her. Really big raise. So Kenya and Latoya landed. A couple of points that I just saw. So they just showed at the bottom how long the flight time was. It was an hour, y'all. She made sure they got there in an hour. So that's how she afforded that jet. Low key, I think Kenya could at least have Cynthia on there too, or Candy. But I think that would have been too much dividing the ladies as well. So just how Kenya and Latoya got to South Carolina in 1 hour, the rest of the ladies are on the bus and it has been 4 hours. And it looks like they're over it now. And they're fanning themselves because they're hot, they're annoyed, and they're probably restless. Oh, so what are they talking about? Sex, of course. They're talking about threesomes. That is always the go-to in conversations. Y'all notice that? I remember in Beverly Hills, at dinner at Denise Richards' place, like they had the conversation about threesomes. So now they're having the conversation about threesomes. And Candy's just giving us a fun fact that she's had threesomes before and she makes them sign NDAs. And that's how you're supposed to do it. So Kenya and Latoya get to the house first. And I gotta say, this is beautiful. This is really nice. It overlooks the beach. Personally, that's what I like to do during the pandemic. Just like go somewhere with a few of your friends and just get a big house, maybe near the beach, and y'all can just enjoy each other's company and just relax for a few days and come right back. So they take it upon themselves to assign rooms. It's Kenya, so she's gonna be shady about it. So she gives Marlo the worst room, of course. Ugh, God, I just hate their scenes together. They are so annoying. Like, they're already annoying on their own, but together, oh my God, it is amplified. Like, geez, this is a struggle. So Portia is losing her patience. I mean, I know the last thing a woman, especially a black woman, wants to be is like sweaty and hot. Ooh, and I love that Drew is now earning her keep as a housewife. She's letting all the ladies know, well, yeah, she told me she was getting on a private jet. And then 10 minutes later after the call, she texts me saying not to tell y'all about it. That's how you do it, Drew. You better earn that peach. So now all the ladies see Kenya's post on Instagram. It shows her baby on the private jet. And then that's what sets Portia off. Because she was like, oh, well, she gets to bring her baby. Why couldn't I bring my baby? How come Candy couldn't bring her baby? How come Shamia couldn't bring her baby? So y'all know we've seen this plot line before, you know, on a little show called The Real Housewives of Potomac about bringing babies on trips. So we've heard it all before. Wait, I could do it better. So we heard it all before. It still sounds the same. Anyway, so we end the episode as a to be continued, as ladies are increasingly getting angry at Kenya for not only taking a private jet, but she's actually bringing her kid too. So this episode was a little different than the previous six. I was a little bit more engaged watching. It wasn't all a Best Fiends episode. But hopefully, you know, the shade and the drama, it turns up. I know we're already on episode 7, but yeah, it's getting a little better, a little better. But anywho, y'all, that's it for now. I'll see y'all for the Salt Lake City review. I haven't decided if I want to do a poli side yet this week. I might do the next week because we might see like a 45 conviction. And I would love to talk about that. Oh, yes. Prayers to Alexander Rogers. He's in the hospital right now. Go show him some love on his DMs right now. He really needs it. He's in the hospital alone. Wish I could be there, so shout out to him. Anywho, y'all, like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see y'all soon. Bye.